If you're a designer or developer tired of bulky office mouses, like the Logitech MX Master, it's time to look beyond the usual recommendations. There's a category of mouses built for speed, precision and comfort, designed for eSport but secretly perfect for us creatives. Today I'll show you why I switched from the MX Master to an eSport mouse and why my latest pick, the Lofree HyPace, or any other eSport mouse might just change how you work. At least it changed everything for me and my relationship to mouses. eSport mouses are built differently. They are ultra-lightweight, ergonomic, minimalistic and super robust, plus they're highly customizable. They pack high-end sensors for crazy precision and are durable enough to take a beating, which makes total sense. I mean, eSport mouses are built for eSport professionals, which uses a mouse day in, day out. There's no way an eSport mouse should fail ever, especially not while a tournament. So naturally, those eSport mouse are perfect for professional use. I've tested a few, including the Razer Viper Mini and now the Lofree HyPace. And if you're thinking this sounds too good to be true, trust me, I was there with you. I was skeptical and I started to hate mouses in general. I used the MX Master for a while but gave up quickly. It was just too bulky for my workflow and it even started to giving me some wrist pain after long sessions, which is never an option, especially if you sit in front of your device for the whole day, like from 8 to 10 a.m. p.m. That's why I naturally gravitated more to my trackpad, like this one, and searched for alternatives. And I was so happy as I stumbled upon those category of eSport mouses, and my first try was the Razer. Quick context. I've been a designer and developer for over 25 something years. I'm obsessed with flow and efficiency. For the longest time, I was loyal to trackpads, as it makes the usage of Windows as well as macOS just so much easier and smoother. But when I built my first real workstation at the end of last year or so, I realized trackpads had their limits. For some specialized applications as well as gaming, they literally suck at gaming, literally. You can just not play with a trackpad. Fact. Naturally, I gave the MX Master a shot because that's what everyone recommends. But it felt clunky and sluggish, so I realized I started to ditch it more often to go back to my trackpad, wondering why I hate working with the mouse so much. Why does it feel so wrong for me to work with this mouse? Until I discovered the high-performance eSport mouse sector and was totally blown away. After some research, I stumbled across the Razer Viper Mini Signature Edition. To be totally honest here, this mouse is totally overpriced, especially in the Signature Edition. But I'm still a designer at the end of the day. And I kind of love how it looks like in my environment, especially in my home office. And it matches just so perfectly to my wired setup. This thing was a joy to use, light, fast, precise. I may have lost some features like the silent clicks and the MX Master's magnetic wheel, which can be super handy when you want to scroll some pages or lines of code, but the improvements in comfort and flow was totally worth it for me. It redefined how I interacted with my machine. That was my turning point, and I finally started to enjoy using mouse on my machines. Like mentioned, with the typical office mouse, I started to gravitate more and more back to my trackpad. Fast forward, new office, new workstation, new mouse. I backed the Kickstarter for the Lofree HyPace, made by the same folks known for their premium mechanical keyboards. It caught my eye with its clean design and bold promise, high performance at your pace. I think it's just a beautiful claim and matches perfectly here, especially when you consider the eSport tonality. When it arrived, I was blown away. It looked premium, feels fantastic in the hand, and glides across my desk like nothing else. It's not loud, it's not bulky, and just the right amount of resistance. This thing was built for someone like me, someone like us, professional users who just want to have a flow experience when they're working. But let's be honest, eSport mouses aren't for everyone. If you need a lot of buttons, rely on silent clicks, or love the infinite scroll wheel on the MX Master, you'll miss those here, kind of, and that's totally fine. But if you ever felt like traditional office mouses are slowing you down or just feels off for you, This might be the upgrade you didn't know you need. Let's come to the more interesting part for most of you. Let's talk about the real-world comparison between the Lofree HyPace versus the Razer Viper Mini Signature Edition. Two very different design philosophies, both built for serious performance. Design-wise, the Razer Viper Mini is a solid block of magnesium alloy. Featuring an organic honeycomb raw and industrial design, it feels a bit like it belongs into a high-tech laboratory. In contrast, the HyPace goes for a totally different aesthetic. Its semi-translucent shell gives off this ghost-like presence. You can see just enough of the internals to feel like you're peeping into something futuristic. It's subtle, sleek, and stands out without trying too hard. Both mice keep it clean with a 5-button layout, which means left, right, scroll click, and two additional side buttons. It's all you need for high-speed workflows or gaming precision. I personally tend to get overwhelmed with too much buttons, so this is kind of the sweet spot for me. The next one, our click feel. The Viper Mini is tactile and sharp, every press is loud and assertive. The HyPace in contrast is quieter, more damped, and soft to touch, less drama, more focus, which makes it a perfect contender for the office environment, where people for some reason hate loud clickiness. And then there's the connectivity. The Razer offers both 2.4 GHz wireless via dongle and USB-C wired connection, no latency, pure responsiveness. The HyPace brings a bit more flexibility to the table in contrast. It not only offers the dongle as well as a USB-C connection, it also offers a standardized Bluetooth connection. If you are juggling multiple machines or hate cable clutter, that extra versatility is a big win, especially if you want to bring your mouse with you, or if you just want to travel a lot with it. Overall, both are excellent for professionals who care about precision and flow in their daily work, and they can absolutely hold their own in gaming scenarios. With top-tier sensors on both, it really comes down to your style, rugged and tactile or sleek and ghosty. If you're fine with a more tactile and louder clickiness, like on a mechanical keyboard, the Razer is a good match for you. If you search for something more on the quieter end of the spectrum, the Lofree HyPace could be better for you. Especially if you plan to use it in an office environment, as people tend to be more annoyed by loud clicky things. Choose wisely, but a special tip, if you really want to use it in the office, choose the HyPace. Thank me later. I hope this opened your eyes to a new category of mouses. Esport mouses in generally surprised me, and I think more designers and developers should at least try one. It could completely change how you interact with your tools, whether it's Figma, gaming, or any workflow that involves hours of mouse movement. Once you feel the difference, it's hard to go back. Every time when I use another mouse than one of my eSport mouses, I kind of get frustrated with it and just start to feel how heavy they feel. I not realized it until I used those eSport mouses more often. Now it's your turn. What mouse are you using right now? Have you customized your buttons or gestures for your workflow? Drop a comment. I want to see what setup you are rocking right now and how you tailored it to your needs. Especially if you're a designer. Until next time, stay efficient, stay curious. Peace. Maybe important. Just a moment. I want to use the opportunity to tease my next project, which will be a Figma 2025 onboarding. This onboarding is mostly focused on AI and how a modern designer can utilize AI to build better projects. Naturally, we will start with our first session with some of the basic functions of Figma, but we'll step up our game quite quickly so that you can build layouts in the most efficient way, for sure.